classification is that of the clandestine, or covert secret society. Unlike the overt society, no attempts at public outreach are made on behalf of the covert one. Public admission is not possible, except by invitation only, and, to quote a now cliched precept, if you have to ask, you'll never know. Reasons for this hermetically guarded level of secrecy may vary from organization to organization, but generally one thing in common is that their interests generally extend to widespread global geopolitical infiltration and influence, and at times, highly organized and systemic criminal and terrorist organizations. The secrecy of the covert society is not motivated by tradition or even influence over lower-level members, but necessity. Both the much dreaded specter of the Illuminati and the vow of silence practiced by the La Cosa Nostra Syndicate are glaring examples of the occult operations of a covert secret society. Other times, the revelation of the covert society's existence could cause so much damage to well-established institutions, such as the Priory of Sion or the Bilderberg Group, that their very foundations could crumble, a moment such groups may indeed be hoping to seize upon. Instead, they bide their time, weaving their way into a highly complex web of intrigue and legend, fact and fiction, both insisting upon their non-existence and alternately placing public reminders of their alleged existence in such a way that the idle observer is caught up in a wave of subterfuge and confusion. One such glaring example of this misinformation campaign was the COINTELPRO operation directed by the FBI under Director J. Edgar Hoover between the mid-1950s and early 1970s, which aimed at surveying, infiltrating, discrediting and disrupting domestic political organizations that allegedly posed a threat to national security and existing social and political order, and was explicitly denied by the organization and its director until official documentation of the program was exposed and made public in 1971, prompting an official investigation into its tactics. Leadership in covert societies are sometimes hereditary, being passed down in generational lines akin to monarchism, the reinstitution of which is, in fact, an alleged goal of some of these cliques. Other times, a feigned leadership has been attributed to noted historical and cultural figures through an elaborate campaign of misinformation and well-constructed lore, granting a lineal if seemingly improbable succession of historical validity to the machinations of a society.